Hello, and welcome to this video presentation on Enlighten, efficient real-time global illumination for high and low-end platforms. My name is Nathan, and I'm an engineer from the Technical Department 2 Technology Division at Silicon Studio Corporation who does development for Enlighten middleware. This video will cover three main topics related to Enlighten. First will be product information that covers the basic functionality of Enlighten. Second will be the new changes and features from the latest major release to Enlighten, which is version 4.02 as of the recording of this video. And last will be comparisons with other global illumination solutions, which will highlight performance, workflow, and supported platforms, with particular focus on Unreal Engine 5's Lumen. To begin, let's look at what Enlighten is and its intended use. Enlighten is a middleware solution for real-time global illumination. It provides consistent, high-quality, indirect lighting with the ability to change lighting and render materials at runtime. Enlighten supports a wide range of platforms, ranging from all current generation gaming consoles, such as PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X, to mobile platforms like Android and iOS. It also provides a consistent workflow across these platforms. Enlighten can be provisioned for use with your own game engine, along with in-depth documentation on how to integrate it. It can also be obtained as a pre-integrated package in Unreal Engine 4 or 5 that is already fully incorporated into the engine's development environment for immediate results. For those unfamiliar, I will give a quick explanation of what global illumination is. Here is a cave scene without global illumination, and you can see areas not in direct light are completely dark with nothing visible at all. The only light source is the sun shining through a hole in the ceiling of the cave. Here is the exact same scene, but with global illumination added. The light source is still the same sunlight shining through, but with the light reflected throughout. As in real life, some amount of light still manages to reach even the most occluded corners and crevices. Enlighten's function is to simulate how light bounces around the geometry in a scene and to derive data while doing so, which the host engine can then sample from during rendering. A prime example of where Enlighten provides an advantage is in the ever-growing popular open-world game genre. Weather and time-of-day changes require the need for dynamically updated global illumination, which Enlighten provides. In the video currently playing, we can see as the time of day changes, the lighting is accurately updated. Pay particular attention to the areas not in direct sunlight where only indirect lighting is received. Here is the same scene at different timestamps which highlight the change in light source, and we can see the environment still receives realistic indirect lighting. Next, I will go over the major new features that have come to Enlighten. The following are improvements that apply to both the SDK and Unreal integrations, which are improvements to probe lighting, better looking cube map reflections, and smoother per pixel probe lighting. There are also some Unreal specific updates, which are real-time skylight capture, support for mobile deferred rendering, and support for Unreal Engine 5. Although these changes are listed as specific to Unreal, it is possible to achieve similar functionality within your own engine using Enlighten. Support is also available for contact if assistance is needed when adding these features. Here is a video tailored to show off the improved probe lighting system. At the first video marker, Enlighten is toggled off to show the difference without indirect lighting. Now Enlighten is back on from the second marker. The important thing to notice is the abundance of foliage in the scene, which are all being lit by probe lighting. Enlighten was originally developed as a light map based solution and only partially used probes. Foliage and other complex geometry often result in problems when using light maps, where UVs must be calculated for every bit of geometry. Now with the probe system overhaul, those lighting issues are avoided, and scenes such as these are easy for Enlighten to handle. In addition to that, probe usage provides a more artist-friendly workflow. There have also been improvements to probe placement. The ability to set coarser resolutions than before has reduced light leaks that often occurred around thin walls. Additionally, a feature has been added to automatically place probes along the input terrain data, significantly reducing maintenance costs related to probes. Furthermore, we have re-examined Enlighten's pre-computed data, successfully reducing the probe runtime memory by half. Optimizations have been made to match modern types of games, allowing Enlighten to operate efficiently in AAA level games. We recognize the importance of enhancing probe-related features for Enlighten, and we will continue making improvements in the future. The quality of cube maps has also significantly improved due to the addition of a new filtering option. The left image is the result of applying the conventional box filter, while the right one has the new GGX filter applied. Mipmap generation is also now more physically accurate, especially for materials with higher roughness, which result in more accurate specular highlights and brightness. This improvement does come at a slight runtime cost increase. The transition between different probe levels of detail is now smoothed out, and previously visible noise has been replaced by dithering for a much better result. This can be further improved upon with temporal anti-aliasing if available. The image on the left uses the previous noise solution, and on the right we can see how it looks smoothed out with the new dithering method. Here is the same comparison, but with lighting only, to make the difference more obvious. Here is a video clip that showcases the real-time skylight capture, which was introduced in UE 4.26, and Enlighten has added support to go along with it. With the ability to properly capture the dynamic and specular environment lighting provided by Unreal, it is now easier to achieve accurate changes in time that affect lighting. This is a capture of the beginning and end of the video. You can observe that the dynamically changing skylight is accurately reflected in the indirect light during each time period. To use this feature, you simply need to enable the option on the Unreal side. In the implementation for Unreal, Enlighten has become usable in the mobile deferred renderer. Leveraging the low runtime cost feature of Enlighten, high performance real-time global illumination is now achievable on mobile. The video being played is a capture of actual execution on the iPhone 14 Pro running smoothly at 60 frames per second. We have confirmed that it runs smoothly on mid-end phones such as the iPhone 12 and Google Pixel as well. Lastly, Enlighten is also compatible with Unreal Engine 5. While some features such as world partition have limited support at the moment, we are working towards expanding support and eventually implementing various optimizations tailored for UE 5. Unreal Engine 5 introduced Lumen as a dynamic global illumination solution, but we believe there are still scenarios where Enlighten remains a useful choice. From here, let's take a look at Enlighten when compared to other global illumination solutions. First, let's look at the advantages Enlighten provides. Enlighten calculates global illumination based on the radiosity method. It divides the processing into two main phases to achieve real-time indirect lighting. The first phase, pre-compute, analyzes information from static geometry in advance, which partitions the scene into patches, places probes, and calculates form factors. The second phase, runtime, asynchronously calculates the final light propagation on the CPU, considering the information generated during the pre-compute phase, along with the information about lights and materials. This separation of phases allows the heavy computations to be entirely processed in advance, which results in a cheaper runtime cost. The second advantage is the ability to quickly iterate on lighting adjustments. With Enlighten, once the scene is pre-computed, artists can quickly receive feedback when editing light parameters in the editor. Scene lighting significantly affects visibility during gameplay, and even when artists need to frequently adjust lighting, Enlighten immediately reflects those changes in indirect lighting, which allows for easy modifications of light parameters and a faster workflow. Customers of Enlighten have praised it for allowing extra time for other tasks that was previously spent on lighting adjustments, which has led to an overall increase in quality. Now let's take a look at the features of UE5's Lumen, which is the subject of comparison in this case. Lumen is a GPU-based solution packed with the latest technology, made possible by the recent advancements in GPU performance. Lumen has an incredibly low amount of pre-computation, instead opting for a design where all global illumination updates are performed at runtime. While this allows for immediate verification of the global illumination results, it seems to have raised some concerns about actual device performance and hardware requirements. Here we have an overview comparison of Enlighten, Lumen, and common baked solutions. Both Enlighten and Lumen are considered real-time global illumination solutions because they allow for dynamic lighting and material changes at runtime. Baked solutions only provide indirect lighting for static lights. The major difference between Enlighten and Lumen is Enlighten prioritizes runtime performance, while Lumen gives immediate results regardless of the situation. Due to this lightweight runtime, Enlighten performs well on a wide range of hardware. Let's now delve into a detailed comparison between Lumen and Enlighten. In this examination, we have used the same scene to investigate the differences in appearance and performance between Enlighten and Lumen. The scene used for testing has been the demo created by our company for the presentation of Enlighten 4, which has been featured several times. For this comparison, we used Unreal Engine 5.1 with Enlighten 4.2 and Lumen on Unreal Engine 5.2. For both, we use the same hardware listed here. First, we have the scene at the cave entrance, which represents an outdoor setting. This scene includes a large quantity of foliage and various spheres with different roughness values for clear reflection comparisons. This is the case using Enlighten. In this scene, stable and high-quality indirect lighting is obtained responsively. Due to the nature of the capture, the animation of the leaves may appear slightly jerky, but there is no performance drop or similar issues. Next, let's take a look at the scene using Lumen. While the reflections might appear slightly noisy, the overall impression is that it manages to depict plausible indirect lighting. We include the same scene using path tracing to act as a reference point for comparison. And here are the same video clips side by side. In this scene, you can observe some differences in the indirect shadow and reflections for elements such as the trees and stone statues between the two techniques. Now let's analyze the left side of the scene. Indirect shadows are necessary on the left side of this tree, but they are not as observable with Lumen. On the other hand, for the stone statue in the back, Lumen manages to depict more distinct indirect shadows compared to Enlighten. Now let's examine the right side. In contrast to before, Enlighten manages to capture the indirect shadow around the stone statue more effectively. This variation might depend on the resolution settings and actual placement of Enlighten's probes. Let's now compare the reflections. The left sphere has the lowest roughness setting, while the surfaces become progressively rougher towards the right. Lumen shows strong reflections, particularly on the second sphere with a glossy material. In the case of rougher materials, noise is noticeable in Lumen's reflections. Additionally, when we move the light source rapidly, we notice that the updates of Enlighten's indirect lighting is slightly delayed but refreshes smoothly without much noticeable discrepancy. In the case of Lumen, due to the use of temporal techniques such as temporal anti-aliasing, previous frames' indirect lighting results persist, causing a noticeable delay in the global illumination update. Here is a summary of this comparison using the cave exterior scene. Both Lumen and Enlighten produce results that are similar to path tracing. Lumen seems to excel when rendering indirect shadows, and rapid changes in lighting are more immediate when using Enlighten. The second scene is an interior cave location, which features a large tree on a small center island. Here is a video demonstrating the use of Enlighten. You can observe that the indirect lighting is updated almost without delay in response to the movement of the light source. When the central tree is directly illuminated, the surrounding rocks show a slight greenish tint due to the reflection. Overall, it achieves a natural representation of indirect lighting. Next, let's take a look at the case of Lumen. Here too, the indirect lighting seems to be updated without significant delay, although some flickering is noticeable in darker areas. Additionally, compared to Enlighten, the green tint resulting from the reflection of light from the tree appears to be more pronounced. However, in finer details, the indirect shadow and other lighting elements are clearly visible, suggesting a high level of detail. Again, a path-traced example is included for comparison. Let's also take a look at the results alongside the reference path-tracing version. In comparison to path tracing, Enlighten appears to be slightly brighter, while Lumen seems to be slightly darker. Overall, Enlighten's results are closer to the reference, but the grass growing under the hole in the far left is significantly brighter. This may be due to Enlighten's cube map capturing strong reflections from the water's surface, resulting in an overly bright appearance. Enlighten also seems to lack noticeable indirect shadows around the area encircling the rocks, in contrast to Lumen. However, concerning the reflections from the tree, Enlighten appears to have a more natural appearance closer to the results from path tracing, while Lumen exhibits an excessive green hue. As expected, Lumen produces slightly darker results compared to Enlighten, but it is more effective in capturing indirect shadows. Lumen seems to struggle in such low-lit scenes. As seen in this video, noise is consistently present. And here's the summary of the cave interior scene. Once again, Enlighten tends to be brighter overall, and Lumen expresses good indirect shadows. Also, in low-lit areas, Lumen produces some noise. Here's the summary of the visual comparison. Enlighten smoothly follows the movement of light and provides a good response. It consistently generates results close to the reference in outdoor scenes and maintains natural indirect lighting without significant issues in indoor scenes. On the other hand, Lumen also achieves results close to the reference in outdoor scenes, but it exhibits slight darkness and noticeable noise in low-lit areas, particularly in the cave interior. Additionally, it accurately represents fine indirect shadows. Next, we have some performance metrics that were captured during these comparisons. Enlighten's GPU load is difficult to measure individually due to the nature of its integration, so we observe the overall frame time. Across all scenes, Enlighten maintains a stable load of approximately 8 milliseconds without any significant performance issues. On the other hand, Lumen showed an average load of around 16 to 17 milliseconds with considerable fluctuations. Actual values ranged between 11 to 30 milliseconds. Particularly, there was a tendency for performance to drop during scene transitions. Given that Lumen is currently supported only on high-end platforms, if the goal is to achieve dynamic lighting across a broad range of environments, including mobile platforms, Enlighten appears to be the most effective option at present. Lastly, it is worth mentioning the differences in workflow and user experience. With Enlighten, pre-computation is required when constructing or modifying a scene. The time it takes varies depending on the scale and setting of the scene. However, once the pre-compute data is generated, global illumination can be updated immediately at a lower runtime cost, allowing for a smoother progression of work and lighting adjustments. Additionally, to achieve good performance at runtime, artists need to make appropriate settings. On the other hand, for Lumen, pre-computation occurs only during a minimal bake at the time of mesh import. The advantage here is that global illumination results are obtained immediately upon placement in the scene. While there may be cases where mesh card adjustments are necessary to improve performance, the overall workload for global illumination is relatively low. Here's the final summary of the comparison. For outdoor scenes, both Enlighten and Lumen were able to achieve high-quality results. For indoor scenes, Lumen allows for easy production of high-quality visuals, albeit with some constraints in low-lit environments. Performance-wise, Enlighten has the lower runtime cost, which allows it to operate on a large range of hardware. This comes at a trade-off for pre-compute time beforehand, which Lumen does not require, and why it provides a high-speed workflow for artists. Lastly, the use of pre-compute data allows Enlighten to quickly react to sudden changes in lighting, whereas those transitions were very noticeable in Lumen due to the reliance on temporal data. This concludes the video presentation on Enlighten Efficient Real-Time Global Illumination for High and Low-End Platforms. Thank you for taking the time to watch and for your interest in the product.